Hello everyone, I'm Joseph Adepoju. I would like you to subscribe, like my YouTube channel, Joseph Adepoju, Mount Zion Film Production. Thank you very much. God bless you.
Bye. This is nice.
Nah, this is what is going to wrap your enjoyment.
Okay, let's clean our glasses first. Let's clean our glasses. All right. So, this is nice.
That's sticky,
These people are really enjoying this place like this.
We are not enjoying the work of our
school. They would have locked us outside.
That stupid girl. I'm going to carry a segment from my husband's house. I think she brought a house from her parents' place. Idiot.
And do you know what? You know, I was opposing you when you brought the suggestion that we should come and take over.
Okay, I saw it coming. Yes,
see, see how we are now enjoying it.
I saw it coming.
They've made way for my trip to Switzerland.
Okay.
Oh. The business trip you told me about, Abby.
I'll be in Zurich. I'll be in Geneva. Yes.
Okay. Money has come.
It is very good. Now that there is money, it is good we invest it. So that it can continue to yield.
See how we are now enjoying this. How are you?
Big uncle.
My son. How are you?
How are you?
Sonny.
How are you?
How
are you doing?
Teroba. This is Teroba. And this is Lucy, ma.
Lucy.
Lucy, meet my mom, meet my uncles.
We try. Sonny.
Sonny, you shine your eye.
I took off for you, sir.
Shine your eye, well.
Yeah, exactly, sir.
Come on. Welcome, my daughter. Oh, yeah, eat out of it.
Good color. Nice color.
Take one.
Welcome, my daughter.
How are you? What do you call your name?
Lucy.
Fine name.
Yes, ma'am.
That name is beautiful.
Thank you.
Take chicken.
It's a fine name like the owner of the name.
Is this one? Yes, that's my girl.
Sonny?
Sir?
Get glass now for your girlfriend.
All right, Lucy, this is my home. I mean, you can walk anywhere. Once my mom and my big uncles have accepted you, once accepted by them, and you got no problem.
My son!
Yes, mommy!
That's my son!
Son is our personal person.
Yes.
This place is lovely. Thank you. Beautiful.
We have even accepted this one.
We have accepted you.
Thank you, ma.
He wants to pick you.
Mimi, put us our car now.
Yes,
why can't you go and take our car back?
Uncle Sonny is driving our car and we are suffering here.
We are suffering.
You people should leave Uncle Sonny alone. Leave Sonny alone for God's sake. God will vindicate us.
Mimi, this is money now. We have gone to school. We are not eating anything. We are hungry now.
You think I'm finding it easy too? You people should just take it easy with me now. Leave them alone.
Lord Jesus, you will arise for my cause. Your word says in the book of Exodus chapter 22, verse 22, you shall not afflict any widow or fatherless child. If you afflict them in any way and they cry at all to me, I will surely hear their cry. Father, I have been afflicted, Lord. I have been afflicted. What belonged to me had been forcefully taken. Lord Jesus, you will arise for my cause. Because you said, if I cry unto you, you will hear. Lord, may you hear my cry. In the name of Jesus, arise and fight for my cause. In the mighty name of Jesus, you said they should not afflict me because I am a widow. My children must not be afflicted because they are fatherless. Oh, behold, Lord, I have been afflicted, Lord. Lord, arise for my cause. Fight my battle. In the name of Jesus, Lord, arise. Lord, arise. Lord, arise. Lord, arise. You will fight for my cause. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will arise for my sake. In the mighty name of Jesus, hear my cry, O Lord, and arise and fight for my cause. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will put my enemies to shame. In the mighty name of Jesus, I have been afflicted. Lord, what belonged to me had been forcefully taken. Lord Jesus, my sweats, my husband's property, what we labored for, we will labor for all these things together. Lord, it has been taken. Lord, it has been taken. Lord, I have been afflicted. Will you not arise and fight for my cause? Will you forget about your word? Lord Jesus, you said you honor your word more than your name. You are the Lord that hastened to perform your word. May you hasten to perform your word concerning everyone that had afflicted me. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will wipe my tears away. You will hear my cry. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, arise, O Lord. Arise for my cause, Lord.
And please go and eat.
We should. I'm not eating. Can't you see everything that is happening? See what happened today. Do you like it?
So what are we going to do?
Look at mommy. See how she's always crying all the time. Is that what should be happening?
What are we going to do?
I think we should pray. Father, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, thank you, Lord, for this family.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, for how your hand has been upon our lives since our daddy passed on.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, we pray that you remember your promises to us today. And you fight for us and let us hold our peace in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, I pray that you arise and let your enemies be scattered in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, we don't want to see our mommy crying again. Grant her peace. Grant her happiness.
Amen.
Let her be peaceful in everything she does in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, grant her the peace she deserves in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Sonny? What are these with me now? Let's go.
Yeah.
That wedding is going to be great.
Yes.
Mama di mama.
They will know that some people have arrived.
But they go take, ma. They go take.
Is the car ready?
Yes, yes. Mama, you can trust me now.
Which of the car?
I feel like we should just oppress them. Maybe we should take the red one.
Okay, okay.
Hey.
Let me take my bag. What is it? What is it?
Wait.
What is it?
Ah!
No. Don't do this to us. What is going on? Ben, what is going on?
Hey!
What is it? Hey! Please call the family doctor.
Hello? Yes, yes. Yes, this is Lucy Abbott. What? No, no. Where are they? Where? What hospital? What? God, sorry.
Lady, calm down. The accident was too fatal. But he's getting over it.
Okay, sir. Okay.
So let me see you in the office.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. She'll be fine. I'm coming back now. Sorry.
Their case is very critical. In spite of all medications, the improvement is very little.
Please, sir, Hilda Rufus, what exactly is the cause of all these multiple catastrophes? I don't understand it, sir.
You don't understand? You don't understand? You see, all of them that are hospitalized, they have issues. And you too, they are not careful. You'll be the next target.
Me? God forbid. God forbid. No.
Sir, why all these negative utterances?
Doctor, have you ever seen someone battle against his God and win? This is what happened. I vehemently disagree with all of you on this evil idea of forcefully taking over Philip's property after his death. This is wrong. That is why I've been telling you people, give your life to Christ. You can't be in Christ and be struggling over somebody else's property. And you, Sonny, Philip trained you. He sent you to university. Is this the way to pay him back? To join them in forcefully taking over his property? No, I will not agree.
You have a good point, but you don't need to insult your elder brothers.
No, I'm not. Sorry.
You don't need to insult us. You have a point. I'll think about it.
Tessie, the wife of my son, killed him.
Yes.
He killed him. Tessie, he killed him.
Yes. She did. Because she's a witch. And she wants to sit on all the properties.
That's it.
So me?
This chap, Sunday was living with them. He may have seen the root of it.
Yes.
What do you think?
Brother, you see, I just kept quiet watching what this one is saying. All these SU people, I don't know what is wrong with them. All these things you are talking about, giving life to Christ, what has it got to do with possessing what belongs to us?
A lot!
Come! Wait, when you were talking, I didn't talk. Let me say my own. We sent him to school. The wife killed him. Were you deaf when Sonny's mother was in it?
The wife.
What do you mean? We know them. That is how they will be doing the high express well like this. Just to make sure that they gather sympathy from people like you. And give your life to Christ. What has that one got to do with collecting our properties from a witch? Have you forgotten we sent Philip to school? What? Why should somebody now come from her parents' house to come and sit on what she doesn't know anything about?
It is true. I agree.
Did she bring house from her parents? Or did she bring car from her
and
parents?
And all those big cars.
Elder, I think you need to go back to that your abroad that you came from. It seems your idea is not going together with us.
Which idea?
You follow this kind of...
I'm in touch with the house. I'm regularly in touch with two people at home.
But I don't mind this SU. If we collect everything now, we give a part of it.
I disagree. This thing will backfire.
You will see us enjoying inside that house.
Just go.
We will be enjoying inside that house.
Nothing is going to backfire.
If it backfires, we will use the fire to cook soup. I don't know. All these SU people. Give your life a ride.
Backfire.
Let it backfire.
Olga, this is serious.
I never knew.
Look, the only way out now is to go and look for that widow and apologize to her and return all the properties that they forcefully took away from her and vacate the house that they are staying that does not belong to them. If they don't do that, the worst is here to happen.
The worst? Ha!
Rufus, this pain is too much.
Do you now see the repercussion of fighting against a widow?
Yes. Just help me to beg her.
Well, the Holy Spirit will help me to speak to her. But most importantly, you need to give your life to Jesus Christ, Mama. I said the same to Sonny, and he has done it. So you need to hand over your life to Christ to have peace of mind. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Say, my Lord Jesus.
My Lord Jesus.
Forgive me of my sins.
Forgive me of my sins.
Hello, sir. My name is Elder Rufus Adekomi.
Pastor, good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon. You're welcome, sir.
God bless you. How are you?
Yes, sir.
How is your brother? Bless you.
Thank you, sir.
God bless you.
Thank you, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Ah, good to see you again. I just come for in respect of what we have been saying about this family.
Pastor, I told you don't go there. Please, I beg you in the name of God. Don't bring this up again. I told you. You are telling me they are in pain. Why won't they be in pain? They have not started yet. Pastor, Was I not in pain? Have you forgotten what they did to me and my children? I almost lost my salvation. I went through emotional trauma.
You just have to calm down. Calm down, because I want you to remember the word of God. In the book of Ephesians chapter 4, verse 32, which says, be ye kind one to another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God, for Christ's sake, has forgiven you. You just have to forgive them, please. If you don't forgive them, should rapture take place?
Pastor, leave that. Please leave that. What are you talking about?
Hello, sir.
And what does he want here? Ask him to go out now.
No.
I don't want to see him.
No, no, sister. Let's say, wait, wait. Now, what happened is that this man is a child of God. He is not part of it at all. He is a God-fearing man. He did not take part in the whole episode. In fact, he stood against it. He was not part of this evil plot. And that's why he had to travel all the way to settle this matter. He just had to intervene in it. Please, that's just about him.
Tessie, we know the entire family has offended you. But as a child of God, we are passionately appealing to you to forgive us. For Christ's sake, we all offend Christ at one time or the other, but he forgives us. All the parties involved who carried out the nefarious activities, they are now in serious pain. They are remorseful. They have even given their life to Christ. Before they come and formally apologize, I come to you.
Please,
Mr. Tessa,
Christ is
they threw me out with my children. Right into the cold. Oh my God.
home.
Go back to your house. There's no more there.
Please,
go.
Thank you. Please forgive me. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Thank you. Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
Around.